I used to feel overwhelmed when it came to living a healthy lifestyle. I felt like there were so many things I needed to do. Eat healthy, exercise, take care of my mind, drink water, get plenty of sleep. And while it is important to focus on all of these areas, it doesn't have to happen all at once. Something I've learned during my health journey is that small actions add up. And over time, they can lead to long-lasting healthy habits. Today, I want to share simple habits I've adopted that have improved the quality of my life. The simple habit of slowing down has changed my life for the better. I used to live a fast-paced life, constantly rushing, stressing, and I was really missing out on the beauty of life. Through the practice of mindfulness, I've learned to bring my attention to the present moment and find peace and joy in everything I do. I've become more curious and now pay attention to even the smallest details. As you begin to slow down, you learn to savor every moment, and you no longer find yourself living in the past or worrying about the future. You come to realize that there's no better place to be than here and now. For years, I thought exercise was about forcing myself to do something I didn't particularly enjoy, but knew I needed to do because it was good for me. When I was getting certified in natural health, one of the instructors talked about seeing exercise as a fun, sweaty activity. And I really liked the idea of this because it helped me see exercise as something more than just going to the gym. Whether that's dance, yoga, running, swimming, hiking, you can turn any of these activities into a workout and have fun at the same time. Now I see exercise as simply moving my body in a way that I enjoy. I love the way strength training makes me feel and all the benefits that come with it. So I make it a regular part of my workout routine, along with HIIT cardio workouts and calming yoga sessions to balance it all out. What kind of exercise do you enjoy? Let me know in the comments section below. Our physical health and financial health go hand in hand. I didn't always have healthy money habits. Sometimes I spent money without giving it much thought, and other times I held onto it out of fear that I wouldn't have enough. Having a budget helped me with both of these things. I now decide what my money needs to do for me by giving every dollar a job. That job can be to pay for a monthly bill or save for a vacation. But now I'm mindful of where my money goes and what I'd like for it to do. I no longer spend recklessly or live in fear. The budgeting app I use is called You Need a Budget, or also known as YNAB. I've been using it since 2019, and I highly recommend it to anybody that's interested in starting a budget. It's been so helpful in my life, and I recommend it to everybody that I know. I'll have a link in the description box if you're interested in trying it out. Eating healthy is a habit that is very important to me, but I know it's not always easy. Our desire to eat healthy can be easily sabotaged by the convenience of eating out or indulging too often. Something that's really helped me build this habit and stick to it is by creating a collection of healthy recipes. I do this by trying at least one new healthy recipe every week. If I love the recipe, I add it to my collection. If I don't, I disregard it, but I will try a new one the following week. By doing this week after week, I've slowly built up a collection of healthy recipes I really enjoy, which now makes it easy for me to plan my meals for the entire week. This is a perfect example of breaking down a big goal, which is to eat healthy, into a small actionable step, trying one new recipe every week. As Joshua Becker says, the first step in crafting the life you want is to get rid of everything you don't. As I've practiced decluttering over the years, I've gotten to know myself a lot more. It's taught me to question my values, my preferences, define my style, and actually have a reason for allowing a physical item to take up space. At least once or twice a year, I like to go through everything I own and get rid of what no longer serves me. It's a way of checking in with myself and making sure that everything I own is still aligned with who I am. Every time I declutter, I feel a sense of freedom, and at the same time, I'm creating space to welcome in more of what I truly love. I used to be a people pleaser. I would say yes to everyone. If someone needed me, I would drop everything to be there for them, even if that meant putting aside my own wants and needs. And while it's nice to care for others, I needed to redirect some of that energy back to me and fill up my cup first. Something that's helped me reprogram this is making sure I do something intentional for myself every day. It can be big or it can be small, treating myself to a facial or doing a 5-minute yoga session. Whatever the case is, I make it a point to do at least one intentional thing for me every day. This helps me replenish my energy, and when I fill up my own cup first, I can share with others from a place of abundance rather than scarcity. The most important relationship you'll ever have is the relationship you have with yourself. And just like any relationship, it's important to nurture it. A huge part of my self-love journey has consisted of taking the time to get to know me. Learning new things, exploring different hobbies, a simple journal prompt, or taking a personality test can help me discover something I didn't know or wouldn't even consider about myself before. When you know who you are, you learn to embrace all the things that make you unique. And from this place of self-love, you allow your truest self to shine through. Sleep has an impact on every area of our life, so I'm always looking for ways to improve it. One of my biggest struggles is that I wake up if I start feeling too warm, but I also find it hard to sleep without any covers. So I found the perfect solution for this, which is to use a cooling blanket. If you've ever flipped your pillow over to the cool side in the middle of the night, that's what this feels like. It helps absorb excess body heat and it keeps you cool all night long. I live in Texas and summers here get pretty hot, so I'm especially looking forward to using this when temperatures start going up. I also recently started taking CBD sleep drops about 30 minutes before bed, and the quality of my sleep has improved a lot. I've noticed I not only fall asleep faster, but I stay asleep, and even if I do wake up needing to go to the bathroom, I fall right back asleep without a problem. And this is something that I really struggled with in the past. Consistency is key to seeing results, so I'm excited to continue using them and see how I feel over time. By the way, I'll have a link to everything I mentioned in this video in the description box below. If you enjoyed this video and found value in it, you can help me out by clicking the like button and sharing this with someone you think would find it helpful. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch. I appreciate you, and I will see you very soon.